friends. Just reach down and pat him on the head. What a friendly little guy he is. Yes, he's just a nice little guy.
He's petting him with his feet.
Just like all fish, you've got that gooey slime all over your skin. Now you got it on your hand. Just wipe it off the person next to you. Don't get it on you. That's his fun. All right, he's swimming away. Swing by. Now, people, while you were sitting down on the beach, soaking up the rays, playing with the dolphins, and drinking that golden nectar, I went out and rented Mustang convertibles for each one of us to drive home. It's that hot new Mustang, that Cobra. It's got 600 and some horsepower. It's got a big, fast motor in it. People, we're going to have the road to ourselves. This is going to be a fun ride. So I'm going to count to three. At count of three, I want you to sit up in that driver's seat and grab that steering wheel. We'll get ready to start these cars and drive them home. Now, one, two, three. Just sit right in that driver's seat. Now, we want to be safe drivers, so everybody grab that safety belt. Buckle yourself in. Buckle yourself in. Safety first. We want to be safe drivers. That's good. All right, we're buckled in now. Put your foot on the gas. Get your back knee. Let's crank it up. Oh man, that's a brand new car. Should have started right up. Maybe it's got a bad battery. Maybe we didn't give it enough gas. Let's try it again, people. Mash the gas and turn the key. Oh yeah, we got it started now. This is a fast car, people. We've got the road to ourselves. This is going to be fun. Grab that gear shift, grab it down a bridge, shift it in the gear. We're going to take off. And then one, two, three, shift. We're up to 60 miles an hour, but since we've got the road to ourselves, let's just go a little faster. Shift. We're up to 80, up to 90 miles an hour, cruising down the road. We got the top down, the wind in our hair. You might want to check yourself out in the rear view mirror. One of your friends might see you driving this hot car. You might be looking good, but you know. Just wait for when you go by. Cruising down the road. All we need now is a little music on the radio. Just reach over there, flip the radio on, find some good driving tunes, something with a nice beat to it. Cruising along, yeah, I got some funky music now. Cruising along, 90 miles an hour. We got the top down, wind in our hair, coming up to a sharp left-hand turn. Get ready, people, don't run off the road. Now one, two, three. Left-hand turn. Straighten up, come to a big bump in the road. Coming to a bigger bump. Cruising along, having a good old time, 90 miles an hour. Oh, but wait a minute, there's something behind us, in the rear view mirror. It's lights. Oh no, it's the man. People, he'll never catch us. We're going through now. I think we got away. We pulled up something, didn't we? Right by us. Didn't even see us. Oh, right. But you know, I swear, I thought there were two cars. I only saw one of the lights. I haven't been looking. Oh, no. He is right behind you. You are busted. Oh, no. But people, you got one chance. You've got one chance here. This is a nice cop. He's a good guy. He's a sucker for a good story. You tell him a good story. In fact, people, if you tell him a bizarre story about why you were speeding, he just might let you go. The stranger and more bizarre your story is, the more likely he is to believe you. The more facial expressions you put into your face while you're telling your bizarre story, the more likely he is to believe you, and the less likely you are to get a ticket. That happens when you open your eyes at the count of three. I'm the cop. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Yes, ma'am, you were going pretty fast back there. Can you explain why you were speeding?
I don't remember.
I'll be back to write your ticket in a moment. Yes, sir, you're going pretty fast. Do you have a good excuse, I hope?
I just wanted to drive fast.
Just wanted to drive fast. I'll be back to wait for you in a minute. Yes, ma'am.
There you go.
Yeah, where's the fire? Why were you going so fast?
I was late for prom.
Late for prom. That's important. Why were you going so fast?
There's a dragon chasing me.
I'm going to dragons. I know, it's scary. Yes, ma'am, you were really flying back there. You were just about breaking the sound barrier. Why were you going so fast?
I'm
going
to have a baby.
Wow. You know this is going to happen?
No.
What's going to happen?
I don't know.
Ma'am, why were you going so fast?
I was her husband.
Wow. I thought you were going way too fast back there. Why were you speeding?
I don't know.
Why are you going so fast, sir?
Alerted to cops.
Well, you should be starting to itch right now. Why are you going so fast?
Aliens are trying to abduct me.
Aliens? Those darn aliens. Yeah, you got to drive fast to get away from them. Why are you going so fast?
Donuts run, too.
Oh, why are you going so fast?
I thought
we were racing with their restaurant.
Why are
you going so fast, sir?
It's a fee.
All is nature. Yeah, well, I understand that. Why are you going so fast, man?
The cops are chasing me.
Yeah, that was me. I caught you. Yes, sir, why are you going so fast?
A new video game came out.
Video game. New video. You gotta get there first. You gotta get that video game. Why are you going so fast?
I thought if I sat still, you
would
have seen me.
I can't wait for this one. Yes, sir, you were really going fast back there. Why were you speeding, sir?
I was running from the cops!
You want to run really fast next time. Alright, in my hand I have some magic pixie dust. I've got the Sandman's magic pixie dust in my hand. I'm going to sprinkle this dust on each of you. And when I say the word sleep, you're all going to go into a deep, 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 relaxing sleep. A deep, 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 relaxing sleep. You've got your pixie dust. 1, 2, 3, sleep. Sleep, sleep. Way deep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Deep, relax. Let's take them all deeper, relax. Give them a mic round of applause. If you can please. That's good, people. Just relax and enjoy that pleasant feeling. In just a moment, I'm going to count to three. At the count of three, you're going to sit up with your eyes open, feeling wonderful in every way, comfortable and relaxed, happy to be among friends. And when you open your eyes at the count of three, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and only this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes at the count of three that any time I say the word hypnosis, each and every time I say the word hypnosis, you suddenly look down at your shirt and realize that shirt is on backwards. Since that annoys you quite a bit, you immediately have to pull your arms in, spin that shirt around to get it on straight. Each and every time I say the word hypnosis. In addition to that, when you open your eyes at the count of three, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and only this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes at the count of three, standing right in front of you. No, it's not a microphone stand. It is the most beautiful person you've ever seen in your entire life.
Yeah.
That beautiful person has eyes for you. You have eyes for that beautiful person.
Can they take anybody better?
You immediately give up. And give that group of person a big kiss. And hit you with your eyes and began to breathe. And in addition to that, when you open your eyes and began to breathe, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and only this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes and began to breathe. Anytime I say my name, Dan Sanders, you suddenly stop what you're doing, you stand up and shout to everyone in the room in a very loud voice, I've got a wedgie! When you open your eyes, the count of you. And in addition to that, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes, the count of three, you no longer remember the number six. You no longer remember the number six. That number is now completely gone. It's erased from your memory. It's no longer there. Your mind can't think it. Your mouth can't say it until I snap my fingers or you leave the room tonight. You no longer remember that number. When you open your eyes, and at the count of three, and are ready to respond enthusiastically to these suggestions. At the count of three, sit right up with your eyes open. And now one, two, three, eyes open. Stand up. Pretty nice looking. I think she likes you. You have to fuck her. She wants a kiss. Oh, you need a big one on a man. Put your arms around her. Slippers and tongue, you know she likes that. And then you have 10 more seconds to kiss her, so kiss her good. 10 more seconds. Now, come up to her, Romeo. Just sit there and talk to her, man. Get to know her. She looks like a really nice person. So just get to know her. Talk to her. And get to be friends. Just have a seat right there and get to be a friend with her. You look like a really nice looking couple. So we're going to begin our demonstration in just a moment, our demonstration of hypnosis. You'll find the darndest things will happen. It is a relaxing process.
What?
Hypnosis is a relaxing process.
Hypnosis
is something that comes pretty naturally to us. In fact, I often use hypnosis when I'm flying an airplane. It helps me relax. I can stay through the flight. And if I hypnotize you, that's called heterohypnosis. It's called self-hypnosis. And hypnosis is a relaxing process. something wrong there. Then we need to count over, try that again, count over again. Over my mind. Let's do that again. Here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And the other one is going to bring it up to the surface. So it's kind of like that. How many fingers do you have?
10.
Yeah, you sure? Count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
How many do you have?
10.
Count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
You does have 10. Let's count yours one more time. Let's try it. You must be doing something wrong. Let's do this. Put them together. This time we'll count by twos. 2, 4, 8, like that. Turn sideways.
2, 4, 8, 10, 11.
Is it 10 or is it 11 or 12? Which is it? That's weird. Why are you putting this in? Maybe we can figure that out. Maybe we can figure it out later. You two did really good together. Did you get her name?
No.
I don't really care, do you?
No.
What about it?
I don't know.
Stand up with it one more time and stand up with it. Bring it forward. Bring it forward. You get to kiss her one more time. You only get 5 seconds. Give her the best kiss. Make sure she remembers you. Remembers you forever just from this last kiss, okay? 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, go. 5, 4, 3. Can you realize what you're doing? 1, 2, 3. What's going on with my stand, man? Is that in your way?
Yes.
Want me to just move it for
you? Yes.
Alright, I'll just move that right over here. Okay, you can have a seat there. That's good. I don't... Come back here, man. Come back up here. We're getting ready to do that hypnosis thing. Well, hypnosis is. Hypnosis is the relaxing experience. Hypnosis is something that anybody can do. I do hypnosis to help people who are talking. I use hypnosis to help people manage their weight. I use hypnosis to help people stop biting their nails. My sleep gun shoots very powerful sleep bullets. Those bullets don't hurt you, but when I shoot you with this sleep gun, you instantly go right to sleep, which is... Shoot it over here, it's going to ricochet off that wall, hit the back wall, hit that wall, hit you right between the eyes, and put you right to sleep. Here we go. Okay. You'll find when you open your eyes to the count of three, you are now a macho male bodybuilder. Here to compete in the Mr. Bellefontaine bodybuilding contest. You will have all the qualities, all the attributes of a male bodybuilder. You'll have a male name, a male occupation, big, massive muscles. As we all know, bodybuilders are very competitive. You'll have that quality as well. It happens when you open your eyes at the count of three. Ready to respond enthusiastically to these suggestions? One, two, three, eyes open. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the macho male bodybuilders here to compete in Mr. Bellefontaine bodybuilding contest. Just stand up, bodybuilders. You can tell these guys have been working out. They're all pumped. They've got big, massive muscles, ready to compete. I want to do a quick interview with each bodybuilder, then we'll have pose down number one. Let me start with you, sir. What's your name, sir?
George Washington.
George. How much can you lift, George?
Lot.
What's your name, sir?
George Clooney.
Clooney, how much can you lift?
250.
250. What's your name, sir?
Pancho Libre.
How much can you lift?
450.
450. Your name, sir?
Tarzan.
How much can you lift, Tarzan?
1,000.
Now, what's your name, sir? Your name?
George Washington.
How much can you lift?
House.
House. Your name, sir?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnold, how much can you lift?
800 pounds.
800. Your name, sir?
Dick.
How much can you lift? World. Your name, sir?
Bob.
How much can you lift?
10 pounds.
10 pounds. All right, let me step out of the way here. Let me step out of the way. At the count of three, I want you to flex your muscles for the audience and the judges. One, two, three. Flex those muscles really hard. While the audience takes pictures of those big, massive muscles. Flex those muscles really hard. Pose down number one. The judges are scrutinizing your poses. Make sure that you flex those muscles really hard for the judges. Look at those big, massive muscles. You can tell these guys have really been working out. Oh, yes. The trapezoids, the deltoids, the biceps, the triceps, the pectoralis, the quadriceps. All right, just relax, bodybuilders. While the judges are tallying up the scores for round one, I'm going to do another quick interview with each of you, then we'll have pose down number two. And so let me ask you, sir, what are your best muscles?
My biceps.
Biceps, the guns. What are your best muscles, sir?
The guns.
The guns. What are your best muscles?
My pistols.
What are your best muscles?
Quads.
The quads. The quadriceps. What are your best muscles?
My calves.
Your calves. What are your best muscles?
Pecs.
The pecs. You can see the world above. What are your best muscles?
Everything.
Everything. What are your best muscles?
Gluteus.
Gluteus maximus. All right, well, at the count of three, At the count of three, the judges are ready for pose down number two. So at the count of three, flex your best muscles for the audience and the judges. One, two, three. Flex those muscles really hard. Flex those muscles really hard. Show them your best muscles. At the count of three, you realize what the heck you're doing. One, two, three. I could be mistaken, but it looked like you were just showing off your butt. What were you doing?
Showing off my butt.
What were you doing?
Showing off.
Why were you doing that? What were you doing?
Being in a bodybuilding contest.
What were you doing?
Showing my legs.
Why?
Because they're nice.
And what were you doing?
I was a bodybuilder.
You were. What were you doing?
Stretching.
You were just stretching a little bit? Is that what you were doing? What were you
doing? The guns.
What were you doing?
Flexing my biceps.
Okay. All right. Well, everybody have a seat. Just have a seat there. Man, who did that? Woo! Somebody freaks. Man. Somebody. What is going on? Man. Man, did you do that?
No.
Who did it? She did it. Who did that?
Totally him.
Yeah. Man, does it stink over here too?
Yeah.
Who did it?
Him.
Yeah. It was him. Does it stink over here too, man?
Oh my God, dude.
Woo! Who did that?
Right there.
She did it. Oh. Who did that?
Me.
Man, can you believe he did that? It wasn't me. Does it stink over here too? Who did it?
It was her.
It was her. Stink over here too?
Yeah.
Think he did it? Oh, man. Man, does it stink over here too?
Oh, yeah.
Who did it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. Well, I'm going to count to three. At the count of three, you're going to realize it was you, and you do it again. One, two, three. Why did you do that?
It was an accident.
An accident. Do you feel better now?
No.
Oh. Can you believe she did that?
I'm so sorry.
That was you too? All right, down to three, you do it again. One, two, three. Why did you do that?
I don't know.
Feel better now?
No.
Oh. At the count of three, everybody cuts one. One, two, three. Oh, man. Did that tickle a little bit coming out?
It hurt.
Hurt. Oh,
oh,
man.
Oh, God.
Woo. At the count of three, the smell goes away. You forget all about it. One, two, three. Alright, so everybody just sit straight up in your seat. Feet flat on the floor. Everybody watch my hand. Watch my hand, watch my hand. Right at my hand. And as my hand goes down, sleep, sleep, sleep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Deeply relaxed. Let's take them all deeper relaxed. Give them all a polite round of applause. Please. Deeply relaxed. Deep and relaxed. And in a moment, I'm going to count three. At the count of three, we're going to have a little dance contest. At the count of three, we're going to have a dance contest. And in this dance contest, you're trying out for a part in a new reality TV show that's going to come on right after Dancing with the Stars. We can't reveal the name of the show yet, but you get a chance to show your stuff when you do your dance. What the judges are going to be looking for is not necessarily how fancy you are or how well you dance. They're looking for personality. They're looking for something that expresses you. They're looking for something unique, something that's all about you, something that makes you happy, something that makes you feel good, something that works for you and you alone. They're looking for individuality in this dance contest. So when you open your eyes at the count of three, you'll hear that music. As soon as you hear that music, you're going to get right into the groove. You're going to be ready to dance. You'll stand right up in front of your chair. You will stay in front of your chair until your number is called, starting from right to left. We'll call number one. Each one of you will take turns. I'll give you 4 or 5 seconds each to express your individuality. And if you win this contest, you get to participate in this reality TV show. You could be a big star someday. That happens when you open your eyes at the count of three. And now, 1, 2, 3. Eyes open. Oh, yeah. You can feel the music now. Stand up, people. You can feel the groove. You're getting into it already. Oh, yeah. Just make sure you have your feet. Dance, people. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You got that feeling now. Watch my hand. As I lower my hand, everybody, sleep. Wait. Give them all a polite round of applause. Thank you for that. That's good. And in just a moment, people. In just a moment, I'm going to count to three. At the count of three, you're going to sit up with your eyes open, feeling wonderful in every way, comfortable and relaxed, happy to be among friends. And when you open your eyes at the count of three, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes at the count of three that you are now 6 months pregnant and you feel every bit of it. That happens when you open your eyes at the count of three, ready to respond enthusiastically. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Oh man, you guys are so big. You guys are huge. That looks a little uncomfortable. Man, how did that happen, man?
I don't know.
How does that feel, dude?
Uh-oh.
How does that feel? You look a little uncomfortable here. How does that feel?
Came out of nowhere.
How did that happen, man?
They didn't pull out.
Does your family know about this? You gonna tell them?
I have to.
Man, how do you feel?
Hurts.
Hurts.
Man, what happened, man? How did that happen?
I don't know. I got to pee.
Man, and you know, at 6 months, those babies are pretty active, too. They kick pretty hard. In fact, you feel them kicking now. They're kicking so hard. That guy's going to be a soccer player. Girls, put your hands on their tummies and feel those babies kicking. You can feel them kicking. Can you feel them kicking?
Ah!
You feel that baby kicking?
Oh, yeah.
You feel that?
Feels weird.
Yeah, I know. All right, well, I'm going to count to three. At the count of three, you're going to be 9 months pregnant, and you feel every bit of it. One, two, three. Oh, man. You guys, you're huge, man. You look like you could pop any time, man. How's that feel?
Oh, I got a poop.
Man, how's that feel?
Get it out.
Man, you guys are so big. Man, that must be uncomfortable, man. How's it feel?
It feels awful.
How's that feel, man?
Get it out.
All right, I'm going to count to three. At the count of three, you're going to have that baby. It's going to pop right out. You're going to catch that baby right in your hands. It might hurt a little bit. You might have to yell with pain, but that baby pops out. You catch it right in your hands at the count of three. And a one, two, three.
Oh!
Oh! Babies! Babies! We got babies. All right. Yeah, check it out. What do you got, a boy or a girl?
I don't know.
Wipe it off here. What is it?
Girl.
Girl. How much does she weigh?
Like 40 pounds.
What do you got, a boy or a girl?
It's a boy.
Boy. What did he weigh?
Like 7 pounds.
7 pounds. What do you got, a boy or a girl?
Boy.
What did he weigh?
Too much.
You got a name for him yet?
No.
What do you got, a boy or a girl?
A girl.
Girl. What did she weigh?
500 pounds.
Big girl. What do you got, a boy or a girl?
Girl.
A girl. How much does she weigh?
7 pounds.
Got a name for her yet?
No.
What do you got, a boy or a girl, man?
It's a boy.
Boy. Well, what did he weigh?
Probably about 10.
Big boy. What do you got, a boy or a girl?
Girl.
What did she weigh?
300 pounds.
What do you got there, man?
Boy.
How much did he weigh?
10.
10 pounds. You got a name for him yet?
Junior.
All right, well, you know, when those babies first come out, they are really hungry. You know what that means? Got a nurse. Got to whip the nip. You got to nurse those babies. You got to have good infant nutrition. You got to feed that baby. Come on, they're hungry. Let's go. Let's get to work. You got your parental responsibilities here. Feed that baby. Nurse that baby. We're going to make sure those babies are well fed. Girls, if you give them just a little privacy while they nurse, I'm sure you understand. All right, baby's fed. Now you got to put him on your shoulder and pat his little back. You got to get the gas out of his tummy so he doesn't have any discomfort. Just pat him on the back. Pat that back. Get the gas up. Oh, he just did something all over your shoulder, man. Oh, no. And now there's something coming out the other end. Uh-oh. Oh, no, we got a mess. We got to change diapers. We got to change diapers. Take the dirty diaper off, throw it under the seat, put a clean diaper on. Girls, you might want to help them out a little bit. They probably don't have a lot of experience with it. You might want to help them out, make sure they do it right. We got to have good infant hygiene here. Oh, come on, help him out. He doesn't know what he's doing. Help him out. Come on. We got to have clean bottoms on these babies. Gotta get to work, man. Get to work. You'll figure it out.
No.
We got to have good infant hygiene here. All right, let's just rock the babies to sleep. Rock them to sleep. There you go. Rock those babies. Rock those babies. Now, that baby's going to start, it's going to start screaming in just a minute. If you don't sing it a little lullaby, he's going to start screaming and he won't shut up. So you better sing him a little lullaby. Let's hear it.
Rock the lullaby. Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
You're going to sing your baby or he's going to start screaming and he won't shut up.
Please shut up.
Sing your little baby. Sing him a lullaby.
Apple bottom jeans. Rock the birthday. Go to sleep.
Boots with the
fur. All right, count of three, baby. Nurse comes and takes the babies away. Babies are gone. At count of three. One, two, three. They're gone. They're gone. All right, let me just talk to one or two of you here. Let me, I like to get to know some of the people. Go to a new place, meet new people, and let me ask you, man, what kind of music do you like? You got a favorite artist?
Me.
A favorite artist, a recording star.
Lil Wayne.
Lil Wayne? Yeah. How about you? Do you have a favorite store?
No.
What kind of music do you like?
Anything.
Anything? Really? How about you, man?
Anything.
Really? You guys are easy to please. Do you have a favorite star?
Katy Perry.
You really like Katy Perry, huh?
Yeah.
You have a favorite song by Katy?
Firework.
Yeah. Yeah. You have a favorite artist?
Maroon 5.
You have a favorite song by them? Yeah. Katy Perry, huh?
Yeah.
What was the name of the song you like so much?
Firework.
Yeah? Yeah, let me ask, what about some of the rest of you? What about you, man? You have a favorite artist?
Kenny Chesney.
Chesney, yeah. Do you have a favorite song by Kenny?
I like them all.
And, I'll tell you what. Everybody sit straight up in your seat, feet flat on the floor. Everybody watch my hand, take a nice deep breath in. Sleep. Way down deep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And in just a moment, I'm going to count three. At the count of three, you'll sit right up with your eyes open. When you open your eyes at the count of three, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you'll find when you open your eyes at the count of three, whenever you hear this music, whenever you hear this music, you suddenly realize that you are a world-famous ballerina. As soon as you hear that music, you get up and swing into a lovely ballet. You have a very unique style. You're very energetic, very entertaining. You're one of the world-famous ballerinas. When you hear that music, you get up and swing into a lovely ballet for this wonderful and very appreciative audience here tonight. That happens when you hear that music. And you do it with a smile on your face because you love what you do. You love to do your ballets. When you open your eyes at the count of three, in addition to that, this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, and only this person whose shoulder that I'm touching, you will find when you open your eyes at the count of three that whenever you hear let's pick a song. Whenever you hear this music, you suddenly realize that you are the one, the only, the king of rock, Elvis Presley. You returned from the grave. Actually, you never went anywhere. You were here the whole time. You are the original. You are the one and only Elvis Presley. You get up and do a concert for these wonderful people, this wonderful, all these Elvis fans here tonight. It happens when you hear that music, when you open your eyes at the count of three. And for each of you people, when you open your eyes at the count of three, you'll find that anytime I'm facing you, everything's perfectly normal, everything's fine, but as soon as I turn my back, you realize my pants don't have a bottom. My bottom is bare when my back is turned to you, only when my back is turned to you. That happens when you open your eyes at the count of three. Ready to respond enthusiastically to these suggestions. Everybody sit right up with your eyes open. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Think you're all gonna do very well. Everybody looks really good and relaxed. Now, I need to talk to the audience for just a moment. I'll be right back with you. Now, of course, my suggestions are not real, but because of the state of mind they're in, they may seem very real to them. And, oh, look, somebody dropped a quarter. Let me just pick it out on. There's nothing like finding a little loose change on the floor, but it's not my quarter. I really should just put it right back where I found it from. But at the count of three, I have my clothes on, but you're sitting on stage completely naked. 1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh, people, where are your clothes?
Where are your clothes? What are you doing? Where are your clothes? Where are your clothes? Where are your clothes? Where are your clothes? Oh my gosh, why? You people are crazy. What is going on with you? What's your parents going to say?
Oh, jeez.
Well, I'm going to count three. At the count of three, you have your clothes on, but the whole audience is naked. 1, 2, 3. Check those people out. Oh, man. Can you believe those people? Dude, see anything you like?
Oh, yeah.
Can you believe those people?
My mom's out there.
No. At the count of three, everybody has their clothes on, you forget all about it. One, two, three. The darndest things will happen under hypnosis. Hypnosis is a relaxing process. You just never know. You just never know what's going to happen next. Okay, well, the darndest things will happen under hypnosis. It is a relaxing process, a very relaxing experience. And, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the one, the only, the King of Rock, Elvis Presley! Because we did come here to have fun tonight. Fun is what it's all about, and we want to enjoy ourselves, and you never know what's coming up next. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the world-famous ballerinas as they move across the stage with grace and elegance, interpreting the music with their movement, moving like poetry in motion with such grace and style. At the count of three, they suddenly become Chippendales. One, two, three. Here they come, ladies, the hottest hunks in town, shaking their groove thing just for you. I could be mistaken, but it looked like you might have been dancing or something.
Not me.
Why not?
I don't know.
Dance?
Not
usually. Not usually, yeah. Just checking, man. I could be mistaken, but it looked like you were just dancing or something. What were you doing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What were you doing, man?
Dude, I was getting into it.
Alright, have a seat. Alright, everybody sit straight up. You see feet flat on the floor. Watch my hand, watch my hand, watch my hand, watch my hand. As I lower my hand. Give them all a nice, polite round of applause one more time, if you would, please. Before we leave, really nice. That's good. Now, people, in a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 5. As I count from 1 to 5, go slowly.